Mom, have you seen a paper with some random words on it? How will I get my crypto without key?
This can be you if you don't take care of your password. But it's very normal. Actually, it can happen with anyone. But in this video, I think I have got a solution for you. Keep watching. Many of my friends have asked, if they want to hold crypto for long term, what wallet should they use? Are the exchanges good for this? And I've always suggested them. Use a wallet which gives you the private key and is directly linked with the blockchain. What do I mean by this? Let's understand this first before understanding the concept of passwordless wallet. When you buy a coin on the exchange like Binance or Coinbase, they act as custodial wallet, which means you don't get the private key and you don't have control on your own assets. Now imagine if these exchanges are not working in your region for some reason. It can be a tedious process to buy and sell crypto or even access your crypto. So to increase the level of security, you need a non-custodial wallet, which gives you full access. In this, you get a private key, which is used to trade with the crypto. But with this, there is another issue. What if you lose your private key, or you lose a password for a wallet like MetaMask or Trust Wallet, which stores the private key for you? I recently found a solution to this with new type of wallet named Zengo. When I got to know about the app, I wanted to test it. And I must say, I really like the idea of passwordless entry. But then how does this app secure crypto? This app uses the mapping of your face to create encryption of the private key and then stores it in your cloud service, which is Google Drive for Android phone and iCloud for iPhone. I liked how easy it was to create an account. I opened the app, entered my email address. Then this app asked me to verify the email. I did that. And then it asked me to store my face map. The process was quite seamless, and without entering any password, I was able to create my account. I also read about the security of this app online and found how technology is really advancing to store private key in phones and cloud securely. This app was actually using the latest technology seamlessly. I'll not go too much into details or technicalities in this video, but if you're interested to understand the technology behind this, I suggest you to read this blog. Link will be in the description. Now, another problem in case of wallets is you might lose your phone and you need private key stored somewhere to access it. So I wanted to test how easy it is to recover my account in Zengo in case I lose my phone. For this, I uninstalled the app from my phone and installed it again. I entered the same email address and it said it already exists, and to verify it asked me to show my face. Cool. I showed my face again and it recovered my account on the app. That's super easy, right? I don't need to save my private key anywhere, and my face is actually acting as decryptor to recover my key. Since I was reviewing this app, I wanted to test its other feature as well than just passwordless entry. So I went to home menu and I tried to buy $100 worth of BTC. I clicked on the coin, then actions, and then option to buy. I found payment could be made using the card, and fees for buying BTC was also quite low, hence entered my card details, but it did not work. I tried another card, then another. There was some issue, hence I contacted the support. One good thing I liked about the app was its support. I got a reply from them within 8 minutes. They informed card payment is not supported as of now in India, hence suggested me to use Zanpool.com for UPI payments. I followed the steps then on Zanpool.com, had to verify my account first by uploading my address proofs and photo IDs. Now the Zanpool had its own waiting time to verify account. So in the end, I transferred some BNB worth of $100 from my Binance account to app to test this wallet. To do this, I clicked on the receive, copied the address of BNB. You can do it on crypto of your own choice also. Then I opened the other app from which I wanted to transfer the funds. Pasted the address, confirmed, and done. I received the funds within 3 minutes this time. This wallet had very easy option to send or sell the crypto as well. Click on the crypto, click on the actions, and then click on send. I have entered the wallet address and the memo of BNB which I got from the Binance app. And yes, I was able to transfer the BNB. The process is quite simple. Trading, which also means exchanging, was also quite easy to use on the app. Apart from selling and buying, there is also a feature to earn from this app by lending or staking. Don't know what are these? Let me tell you quickly. Let's understand what is staking. Staking is putting your crypto to work. basically you are not doing anything but giving crypto to miners who then use these coins to mint more coins by doing transactions on the blockchain. As a result, you also get some crypto in return. ZenGo wallet gives you option to do staking with the Tezos as of now. And what is lending in crypto? Another way for you to earn in crypto is by lending the crypto to financial institutions like Nexo, which then gives crypto to people on loan and earns interest and share that interest with you. In case you plan this, ZenGo gives good returns on Bitcoin lending. Process to do this was quite easy on ZenGo. Click on actions, select the crypto you want to lend, as of now it's Bitcoin. You see on the screen I did not have BTC, so I added it using the receive feature, which gave me an address to send BTC. I transferred around 0.003 BTC in ZenGo wallet using Binance. Keep in mind, there is a network fees involved. At the time I am doing this video, it's about 0.0005 BTC. So effectively, I received 0.0025 BTC out of 0.003. I clicked on deposit, entered the minimum BTC required to lend, that was around $105, confirmed the transaction, and yes, it's done. Doing this was quite easy and fast on this app. Now last but not the least, another thing I really liked in this app is its customer support. You can easily ping them rather than emailing and waiting for long hours for reply. Let me show you that as well. See, I messaged them at around 12:46 PM about where is my private key. And when I saw the phone at 12:54, there was a reply by actual person named Gaurav. I think he replied before this time. This is cool feature in the app. After that, I had asked lot of questions. They are quick to reply. Overall, I must say this is a good wallet to use if you're planning to hold your crypto or want to earn out of it. Easy to use without much technical details to understand. And cool thing is, you don't need to remember or note down your password or private key. I hope you liked the review of this app. In case you want to know more of my feedback on any of the other features, do put that in comment section. You can also message your questions to ZenGo in customer support section. This is Sukhni Singh signing off. See you next week.